Oh, very cool. You know what's really cool? If you want to design a dream car, I've got the story for you. If you're a student in Hawaii, you can. Now, Glenn Inouye is here from Surfco Hawaii to talk about the Toyota Hawaii Dream Car Art Contest. Aloha, how are you doing?
I'm doing fine. Good morning.
You know, we were chatting in the break. This is a great contest, and for students out there, it allows their dreams to come alive. If anybody doesn't know, though, what is the Dream Car Art Contest?
Okay, Toyota Hawaii is encouraging all students, 15 years under, to enter a contest and develop their dream car.
Mm-hmm. Now, these dream cars, we have some pictures here, but there's no rule. I mean, it's a dream. It's whatever you want. And why is it important for you guys to see these dreams come alive on paper?
Well, I think one of the things that Toyota's is there's three big core concepts that they're encouraging. One is to environmentally safe vehicles. The second is to promote world peace. And third is to encourage helping others. So those are, if they can incorporate those three concepts, they'll be right on.
Oh, that's great. Now, what are some of the details? Because, again, there are places to go. But if they are part of the finalists, this is an amazing journey that, if they qualify, it will take them to Japan, I believe. Is
yes,
that correct?
Yes, that's exactly correct. Then go to toyotahawaii.com for all the rules and guides. But the one thing that is we want them to remember that they have to submit their drawings on 11x17 sheet, which is exactly here.
11x17. Okay, yes. Good. That's the parameters to keep with.
Yeah,
but once
exactly.
You get there, I mean, there's anything you can put down on that sheet, right?
Yes, we'll have three groups, age groups, and three winners, and they'll be their winning drawings will be submitted to Toyota. And if selected, they'll be able to get a trip to Japan to be part of the international contest.
Wow, that's amazing. Yes. Now, I got to ask you, how long have you guys and Toyota, more importantly, been part of this great program?
Toyota's had this contest for over 10 years
now.
Wow.
I got to ask, you know, we had some of the winners last time come on, and it was amazing because when they went to go visit Toyota and they talked to the designers, they were listening to these ideas that the kids came up with and incorporating into their cars, their concept cars for the future. I mean, that's amazing, isn't it?
It is amazing. We actually had three winners from Hawaii that entered the contest in 2012 at Emily Stone from Kaneohe. She was one of the whole representative for the entire U.S.
That's amazing.
And in 2014, we had two winners, one from Kauai, Emma Thane, and Thea Laupapa from Kapolei. So we've had three winners in about 5 years that got to go to Japan with their parents.
And that's great, and that really shows, I mean, for Surfco Hawaii too, what is it like when you have such a great response here in Hawaii of the kids, the future generation of designers, of buyers that are coming up and winning this contest?
It is amazing. If you see some of the entries, they're just amazing. They're creative. Mm-hmm. Very thoughtful, and it's actually really hard
to
judge.
And actually, you have a calendar, right?
Yes, I have
a
calendar.
Sure,
go ahead.
So this is from last year's competition,
last year's winners, all the international winners.
Oh, my goodness.
If so, one of our students gets selected, they'll have their
entries. This is great. So, but like you said, this is a cleaning car for squid and pollution that swims through the ocean and cleans as it goes. I mean, these are great ideas that they have. Now, I got to ask, though, when you were talking earlier, how can students use, you know, these rules, these inspirations? You said they have three ideas, right? Could you go over again about what they should keep with?
The first one was environmentally safe.
Right.
World peace and encourage helping others.
I am fascinated to see how the kids out there incorporate all that into one. That's so cool.
It's terrific.
I got to ask for you, what does it feel like knowing that there are all these kids out there in Hawaii that have such great ideas that really put our design, our students on the map?
It's amazing the creativity out there, the minds of our students. It's amazing. They have some great ideas. And the stories behind how they came up with the concept is even better as you read their narrative. Mm-hmm. It's just terrific.
Yeah, again, now, real quickly, though, more importantly, if there's a student or more importantly, a mom or dad out there that says, my daughter would be great at that, when's the deadline coming up? Because it's very quick, right? We got to get going on
we've
this.
We've got a couple of weeks. It's January 15th that they need to submit their drawings on this 11x17.
11x17 paper. Yes. Again, we'll have all the information leading to your guys' website as well. And again, please, Hawaii has represented so well in this dream car contest. We want to keep that going on, but we also want to keep thanking Surfco Hawaii. Thank you for sponsoring
this.
No, it's great to see you guys behind this and again showcasing Hawaii's future generations of designers.
It's fun. It's a lot of fun.
It is. I love it. Tell me, when you come back, can we see some of the results?
Sure. We'll get them pictures for you.
We'll get that in and we'll follow the story all the way through when they go to Tokyo, Japan. And again, this is a great idea. We'll have all the information on our website.
Can I keep this calendar?
Sure.
This calendar's a good calendar.
It is nice.
Great ideas for the future. You know, coming up on Living 808 in the future, we'll have the latest from Hollywood. We'll also tell you which NBA star is expecting another child and how Steve Harvey himself is actually poking fun at himself for the Miss Universe blunder. Also coming up, things to consider when you're paying off your holiday debt. We'll have more in today's Money Matters.